situation to a close. We're going to separate that resolving the situation to bringing the situation to a close work of TEPCO and putting it into this new organization.
そして東電自体は、私はこれは法的整理というのをここに書きましたが、株主責任、貸し手責任、これを明確にして、企業分割をすべきではないかと私は提案をしています。
And what is written here is that in regard to TEPCO, what I think should be done is legal liquidation, and that's written in this big red arrow. What I mean by this is that we need to review exactly what happened, who bears responsibility, what are the shareholders' responsibility of TEPCO, what are the responsibilities of the financial institutions, banks, etc., that lent money to TEPCO. All of that should be done, and eventually the company should be divided according to its different functions.
あくまでも法的整理というのはありきではありません。一つの考え方の提示でありますが、私的整理もあるかもしれません。いずれにしても、東電が自己収束をしながら事業継続を行うことはもはや困難なことは明らかです。したがって、原子力損害賠償支援機構法の見直し規定に基づいて法律を見直して、そして新たな組織を作り、国がお金を投じて自己収束を図り、東京電力は本来求められるであろう株主責任と貸した責任をしっかりと整理をした形で新東電として生まれ変わらせるということが必要ではないかということを私は今党に提言をしているところです。
So, well, I've written the words legal liquidation, which of course have, are very, very, is a very, very weighty term, which has, implies many, many different consequences. As regarding the actual liquidation, form the liquidation might take, that of course is still up to discussion. It's just that I'm saying that some kind of a very drastic and all-encompassing effort needs to be made in regard to deciding what to do about the future of TEPCO. And I think the first thing that needs to be done, and I will repeat this again, is that the work that TEPCO is currently engaged in which it is trying to bring this accident to a close, that work needs to be taken out of TEPCO.And it needs to be put into a different new organization for which the government, the national government, should also provide money. And in regard to the business part of TEPCO that remains, what will happen to it, the first step that I think needs to be taken is to, again, determine who is legally responsible for the situation that occurred. What are the shareholders' responsibilities? What are the responsibilities of the financial institutions that lent money to TEPCO, et cetera? And after all that has been decided, a new TEPCO can perhaps be reborn.
以上、私の方から汚染水問題に端を発する東京電力の在り方、あるいは国費の投入の在り方、新組織の構築ということについての皆様へのご説明とさせていただきます。ありがとうございました。
So this basically concludes my opening remarks. So to summarize what I've talked about, first of all, I use the topic of the contaminated water issue to talk about some very important themes that I have been pursuing. One is that we should review what should be the ideal form TEPCO should take in the future. We should also review the ideal way, method in which national government money can be put into this Fukushima activities, related activities, and we should think about creating a new organization that is fundamentally in charge of bringing this accident situation to a resolution and also be in charge of decommissioning work as well. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Okay, thank you, Ms. Mabuchi. I just forgot one very important introduction. Our interpreter today, as always, is Tamako-san, Takamatsu Tamako-san.So let's go to the Q&A and allow me to take a liberty of asking first question because I know you have many questions today and we have till 4 o'clock. Mr. Mabuchi, I want to ask first question. Who is opposing this legal liquidation? Is that a finance ministry? Is that METI? Is that a TEPCO? Or what's the obstacle of realizing this?
2年前は、2年半前ですね、2年前ですか、の議論の時には、まあ、一番は、経産省の中ではなかったかと思いますが、資本市場の混乱ということが強く言われました。
Well, two and a half years ago, when this was being fiercely debated, I believe that perhaps many of the voices of opposition perhaps came from within METI, the Ministry of Economics, Trade and Industry, because the phrase that was quite often used was, we don't want to have turmoil in the capital markets.
一番の課題は電力債だったんですね。
the biggest topic of discussion at that time were the electricity related bonds.
Saikens.
The bonds.
でこの電力債というのは全ての債権に優先するという、法律の、担保がついています。法律によって定められています。
The electricity related bonds are a special kind of bonds. They are guaranteed by a special law that says that they received preferential treatment when considering a collateral available.
したがって2年前は賠償債権よりもこの電力債の債権の方が優先しますので賠償金が払えなくなってしまうと、まあ、こういう議論がありました。
In other words, what that means is that once this accident occurred, you had a limited amount of funds, and how is that going to be distributed? Well, according to this existing law, the electricity related bonds had preference, they were given preferential treatment, so they would receive payment first out of the existing monies available, which meant thatThere would be very little money or almost no money left for compensation.
確かあと資本市場の混乱も想像されました。
And as I've mentioned repeatedly, it was predicted that there would be turmoil in the capital markets.
まあ現状においてはもう東電は電力債発行しておりません。そして東電以外の電力会社8社によって、事故以前のその発行市場にまで戻りましたので。現状では資本市場の混乱はないはずです。
発社は発行市場に戻した
と。もう通常発行してるんです。事故後、他の電力会社は通常に発行して、はい、規模も戻りました。
はい。In regard to the current situation, however, TEPCO no longer issues these kinds of special bonds, these electricity-related bonds. And in regard to the other eight electricity-producing companies in Japan, they are have gone back to issuing levels of these bonds previous to the levels before the accident occurred. In other words, things are back to normal.
まあだから今現状は2年後で状況変わりましたので、それでも反対される方はいらっしゃるでしょう。まあもう一つは現状で反対される方は当時緊急融資をした銀行、2兆円の緊急融資をしています。
So several years have passed now, and so I think that the situation has changed very much. Still, there is, I think, opposition remaining to this legal liquidation idea.One of the groups that probably oppose legal liquidation are the financial institutions, primarily banks, that provided emergency funding to the Fukushima nuclear power plant after the accident to the order of about 2 trillion yen.
まあ、その辺の、その、そういった方々の反対が、まあ、今日もあるでしょう。まあ、しかしながら2年経ちましたので状況は変わりました。法定された見直し期限も来てますので、ここは議論はすべきだと思っています。
Having said this, however, although I understand that some parties are still probably opposing the idea of legal liquidation, considering that 2 years have passed, considering that we have come to the point in time when it was originally stipulated in the law to preserve TEPCO, we've come to the point in time where a review is considered.Mandatory or should be done. I believe, therefore, that this is the time when we should review the entire process and the entire situation.
Okay, the question. Okay, let's go first, Christopher.
Süddeutsche Zeitung, Neidhardt. If I understand you correctly, we lost 2 years with this wall, and that's at least 100,000 tons.Of contaminated water. Now, on June 27th, 2011, you were dismissed of that job. Why did you not go public at that moment and assume your civic duty and tell everybody what's going on? But you waited 2 years. And do you regret that you waited 2 years?
2年前はですね、もう皆さんご記憶薄れてると思うんですが、当時近づくこともできないような状況だったんです。したがって今のように観測井戸を掘って、あるいは正確にその汚染水の把握ということがほとんどできない状況でした。ですからあくまで私はシミュレーション上解析の結果漏れ出ていく可能性があるということで 遮水壁の構築を進めようとしたんです。したがって2年前にどの程度漏れているかということを完全把握していたわけではありません。
I would like to explain. First of all, 2 years ago, I'm sure many of you perhaps may have forgotten all of the details since so much time has passed. But 2 years ago, one could not even approach the vicinity of the accident. And so the situation is very different from now. Now we're able to dig wells, holes near the facilities, and therefore be able to check the contamination levels of the groundwater. But at that time, all I could do was basically do simulations on paper and using computers. And based on analyzing the simulation results, I was able to surmise that there was a possibility that contaminated water could actually be seeping out, or eventually could seep out. And that is why, on the basis of these calculations, I made this idea proposal.To build a wall, but I couldn't prove. I had no facts. I wasn't able to access facts to prove my point.
まあ今思うと、東電側はリスクの過小評価をしていました。
Looking back in retrospect, I realized that TEPCO was considering the risks and minimizing the risks. And it was taking a view where the risks were probably very, very low.
まあだからこそ私は多重防御。二重三重の備えということを補佐官時代に訴えてきたわけです。
However, because of the simulations that I had seen and that and based on my own experience and my own views, I believe that one needed to put together protective walls, protective measures, and they should not be just one measure, but they should be multiple measures. In other words, we should put together a multi-layered set of preventive things. That's what I was.Very much emphasizing when I was this aid.
2年前に準備したスラリーウォールは工期2年ですから、やっていればもう終わってました。残念でならないです。
I am filled with tremendous regret because this slurry wall that I proposed 2 years ago, it would have taken 2 years to complete. In other words, if we had started at that time, we would have had that slurry wall in place now. I am filled with tremendous regret.
Okay, next question, Joe.
Joël Lejeune from RTL France. Thank you, Minister, former Minister, for your presentation. Yes, as you said, work need to be taken to take TEPCO out of it, and I wonder why you didn't think about it before, at least to handle reactors. So my question is a bit scientific. I'm sorry for that. It's prior to find the containment solutions,have you and your authorities or authorities since tried to scientifically proceed with sort of simulation of other solutions to cool down reactors? Apparently, and that's what some scientists say in France and I'm sure other countries, apparently there's a possibility to cancel and reduce water and airborne radioactive contamination, not by intensive cooling with tons of water as we have right now,but by cooling with the water spread on the ruined facilities and the melted core, by spreading water, a spray of water, not tons of water like a river falling on the reactors. And the steam which is produced, of course, by this effect would be treated to get at the end a limited amount of high radioactive substances, which would be much easier to store and then to handle after that instead of those...tons of water we have in those tanks. Have you considered other scientific options?
ちょっと最後ややこしかったのがごめんなさい。なんかフランスの方で一つその、検討されているっていうのか、そのシミュレーションをされているようなことなんでございますが、今その、原子炉をその、冷却するためにはもうたくさんの何トンも何トンの水をまあまあ注水しているということなんでございますが、それによってたくさんの汚染水ができるというわけでございます。もう一つのやり方としては、そのまあ上からなんでしょうか、その水をスプレーかける、振りかけるという感じなんでございますでしょうか。まあそれによりますと、もちろんその蒸気も出ますので、まあかなり濃度の高いその蒸気というのが出るんでございますが、それをまあ何らかの形で集めると、最終的にはたくさんの汚染水もその作るのは避けられますし、その高い濃度の水だけを処理すればいいという、そういうようなソリューションも提案されていますが、そういうようなこともご検討されていますのでしょうか。
はい、まずですね、 今お話しあった汚染水を生まないように冷却そのものを考え直すということについてはようやくこれから議論が始まるんだと思います。
First of all, in regard to your first point about trying to think about the contaminated water issue, I think we're now going to embark upon a serious discussion of how we can achieve this cooling effect without producing tons and tons of contaminated water.
チェルノブイリでもご案内のように、あるいはハンフォードを含めて、こうした、その汚染物質を冷やすために水を流し込んでいくということについては、これはもうやってはならないことだというふうに言われています。
In fact, I think through the example of Chernobyl and from Hartford, I think it has been widely accepted now that the idea of trying to cool down these facilities using lots and lots of water is not a very good way to proceed in regard to, in light of the fact that it produces so much radioactive water.
ですから私はすでに経産省には伝えていますが、もうそろそろ空冷です。スプレーまでいかなく、スプレーよりもまだより安全なという空冷。いわゆる崩壊熱が、相当程度下がっているはずですから、空冷状態で、置いていくということも、判断としてこれから検討していかなければならないんだと思っています。
空冷といいますと、冷たい水を
かけるじゃなくて、水をかけるじゃなくて、そのまま崩壊熱で今の状況の中で。
In fact, this is something that I've already discussed with Mitty. I'm saying that perhaps it's about time now that we switch tactics. And I understand your idea about spraying water, but what I'm proposing is that the process is called kure, which means basically to leave it alone and let it cool on its own. The reason is that most of the heat that is produced. That is released. The system has cooled down considerably, and so perhaps instead of not even spraying water or anything else, but just allowing a natural process of letting it cool on its own for a while might be prudent.
で、こうしたこともですね、先ほど私がこの中に書いた、廃炉機構ですね、新たな組織で世界的な知見もここに集約をさせると、もう東電一社に任せるんではなくて、この廃炉機構に原燃や JEA のみならず、それこそ世界中の廃炉研究などをされている機関と連携しながら行っていく独立組織、やはりここでやっていかざるを得ないんじゃないかと思います。
And in fact, including the solutions that you presented and also the solution that I just presented, I think these are the things that should be discussed and taken and implemented by this decommissioning authority, a new organization that I think needs to be established. This would bring together the knowledge and expertise of not only Japan Atomic Power Company and Japan Atomic Energy Agency, which I've had on this list here, but also would have the expertise of experts from around the world. In other words, we would not leave this very crucial and difficult work just to one simple company, TEPCO, but we would establish a new organization.
Okay, all right, go ahead. Ending you.
Representative Mabuchi.
Hi.
Do you plan to introduce legislation into the Diet this session to put any of your ideas into work? Do you have any hope of passing anything given your very minority position in the Diet?
この案も含めてですね、民主党で議論が始まったところです。で、私たちは少なくとも何らかの案を提示をしていきたいと思っていますが、ご案内のように議員立法で出してもこれは成立いたしません。できうればそれこそ超党派、自民党与党も巻き込んでの超党派でのこうした考え方をしっかりとまとめていく必要はあるんだと思いますが、これも今与党の中でどのようなアイデアになるかというのはまさに彼らも検討しているところだと思いますので、今後臨時国会は私はちょっと時間が制約があって難しいかと思っていますが、臨時国会は無理でも通常国会で何らかの形でこの原子力損害賠償支援機構法の見直しと合わせた廃炉の機構なり新自己処理の仕組みというものが提示できればというふうに思っています。
In regard to the kinds of ideas that I have, we've just started discussing the possibility of presenting these ideas to the Diet within my own party, the Democratic Party of Japan. And of course, my fervent desire is to present some kind of a bill to the Diet eventually. But as you've suggested, it is probably very unlikely that if we, the DPJ, on our own present such a bill, it is very unlikely that it will be passed. It has almost no hope of being passed. Therefore, what I think is important is to somehow come to an agreement with some of the ruling parties, including the LDP, to see if we can put forth a bill that will have the support of multiple parties. Having said this, however, I think the ruling party, the LDP, is at present within its own ranks trying to determine what would be the best way going forward. Because all of these discussions are just beginning to build up steam, I think it would be very difficult, considering the time restrictions, to hope for something to pass, be presented and passed during this current extraordinary session. However, I'm hopeful for the next ordinary session that something might be done. And again, it would be a set. We would not simply propose a new bill, but we would also push forward a review of this law that was passed 2.5 years ago to basically rescue TEPCO and take care of the compensation activities.
Mabuchi-san agreed to stay a little bit longer after 4 o'clock, so we can take probably a couple more questions. Okay, go ahead.
Aaron Sheldrick, Reuters. You talked about this legal liquidation period during which the role or responsibility or liability of bondholders and shareholders would be established. Would this period also include looking at the responsibility, personal responsibility of both TEPCO officials along with government officials, which would include METI, NISA and elected officials?
まず法的整理ありきではありません。私の考え自体も。
First of all, I would like to again emphasize that I've written the words legal liquidation, but of course that is a very, very sort of weighty term, and I'm not saying that's the only way to go. It's just one idea, the idea being that we want to make sure that we go through the entire process of reviewing, which will be done with TEPCO.
重要なことは、どうやって自己収束をしっかりと前に進めるかということ。
In other words, the reason I go through this legal liquidation idea is that the most important thing we have to try to achieve is to create a framework in which we will be able to bring this accident situation to a close.
もう一つは、国民負担をどのようにして最小化するかということ。
And the second aspect that is very, very important is to we have to create a system that will ensure that the least amount of taxpayers' money be directed toward these activities.
その上で、法的整理がひょっとすると選択肢の一つなのかもしれませんが、その時に問われる責任はご指摘のように経営責任というのも出てくるのではないかというのは私も理解をします。
Based on these trying to achieve these two goals, I believe that one possibility is some kind of legal liquidation. In other words, some kind of legal change to the status of TEPCO might be considered. And if that is what is done, then what you've just mentioned, in other words, trying to determine the actual legal responsibilities of the people involved, I think that will be a point of interest.
ただもう東電は経営者も変わっておりますので、今ここで考えるべきはむしろ、国民負担の最小化のところじゃないかなと思います。
Having said this, however, considering that some years have passed and the management of TEPCO has completely changed, I think what would most we should, I think the thing that we should most put our energies in is trying to ensure that the least amount of taxpayers' money is used.
でいいんですかね。
いいですか。
はい。の責任、政府のね、はい、あと、政府の責任、もちろん、当時の判断がどうだったかというのはあるかもしれませんが、私はこう思っています、当時、このような救済スキームで行わざるを得なかったというのは、これは致し方ないと思っているんです、なぜなら、どれほどの補償になるのか、あるいは、その事故そのものが果たして、収まる方向に向いているのかどうかすら、見えていませんでした。今も収まってないじゃないかとお叱りいただくかもしれませんが、少なくとも当時はあの状態で時間が経てば経つほど東電はサドンデスしてしまったかもしれないんですね。したがって とにかく救済のスキームを作らなきゃいけない、資本市場を混乱させてはならないということで、私は当時の方策としては、まあ、これはまあベストに近い方法を選んだんだと思います。
In regard to your question about whether members of the government or the government administration itself bears responsibility, of course, in regard to individual decisions, specific decisions that were made at that time, I think, of course, some kind of review or analysis should be made. Having said this, however, my personal opinion is that at that time, the scheme that we are seeing many problems with right now was probably the only option that was the best and only option that was available. The reason is that at that time there was absolutely no understanding of what kind of compensation, what the figures might actually be in the end. At that time it was not even clear whether the accident was actually moving toward a state of resolution. Of course I understand that some people may say that it hasn't been resolved at all yet, but still at that time we had absolutely no idea in which the direction of the accident after effects were moving. So at that time, I think the voices that were raised about trying to avoid turmoil in the markets, etc., were taken into consideration, and they should have been taken into consideration. I think that was the only scheme that was available at that time.
Okay, next question. Okay, the lady.
Netherlands Press, Judith Stalpers. Also within TEPCO itself, there have been several schemes of building walls. Already in December 2011, there was an elaborate plan, and we were looking forward to it. It hasn't been materialized. It hasn't been come into public discussion either. One concern for not building, I had several talks with people at TEPCO, was that whatever wall you will build, whether it's frozen or your clay one, you get an accumulation of water which cannot go out, which makes an environment where nobody could work anymore around the plants because of the high radiation. Is this concern not part of why the delay of building walls is continuing as it is? If you don't have an environment where people can work anymore, then the accident will never be under control? Question mark.
ご指摘の懸念は当時私も聞いていました。
In regard to the concern you just mentioned, that it was a thing that I heard when I was in charge of this project as well.
しかし壁を作るということはどういうことかというと、地下水の流入を止めるということなんです。
But I'd like to first go over the process again. When you build a wall, what that means is that first of all, you're going to stop the flow of groundwater.
流入を止めることによって大量のその汚染水と地下水が混ざることがこれが止まりますので、で水は入れられますが、この冷却水についてはこれを組み上げていって、いわゆるサブドレーンですね、これ抜いていく、中をドライにしていくということが当時の考え方として、壁と、そしてドレーンをするという、この2つが日本柱でありました。
By being able to stop the groundwater from entering the facilities, you're able to keep the groundwater from mixing with the contaminated water and becoming contaminated as well. Of course, separately from that, you have the water that is being used to cool the equipment. And the idea at that time was to take out the contaminated water and make the insides eventually dry. In regard to the water that is still remaining in the facility, the idea was able to fundamentally to basically dig holes and draw out all of the remaining water in the facilities once you've surrounded that by a wall. So there were two ideas. First of all, to build a wall, make sure no groundwater comes into the facilities, and in regard to the contaminated water that is in the facilities, whether it's above ground or underground, to eventually take it out and drain it and make the entire facility dry.
で、あとは冷却の水はヘイループ循環して回していくと。で、もちろんそこで除去装置によって放射性物質を除去します。ここの放射性物質濃度は高くなります。ご指摘の通りです。
And the other part of that, it was to take the water that was being used to cool the equipment and make a kind of a loop system so the water would constantly be, you know, recycled. And as the contamination levels build up in that water, of course, certain things would be done. For example, part of that, part of those radioactive materials would be taken out through a process, but still, over time, as you've pointed out, this water become the remaining water becomes very highly contaminated.
ここはだから確かに高線量下での作業が求められることになりますが、しかしこれが困難だからといって、とにかく地下水に流しておけば見えないからいいだろうということではないはずなんです。
And so that leads me to your point, which is that yes, eventually you will have a facility where the